Hello and welcome to Umbraco Learning Base. Jonathan here. In this video, I will show you how you can migrate a site to Umbraco Cloud. Before we get started, let's have a quick look at what we're going to go through in this tutorial. First off, we're going to prepare our site for migration. We're going to clone down an empty Umbraco Cloud project. Then we're going to move and merge the files between the two projects. We're going to then generate the metadata for our Umbraco Cloud project. And then we're going to deploy our project to Umbraco Cloud. Great. Now let's have a look at the requirements for your site to be able to migrate it to Umbraco Cloud. First of all, it needs to contain no member data. If you do have member data, these will need to be imported manually after the migration. You also need to not have any obsolete or old packages, as they might not work on Umbraco Cloud as well. Lastly, your site needs to run the latest version of Umbraco. In this case, this is Umbraco 10, and the latest miner of Umbraco. As on Umbraco Cloud, all new sites are running the latest version of Umbraco. Let's now have a look at the tools that you need to have to be able to migrate your Umbraco on-premise site to Umbraco Cloud. So first of all, you need to have Git installed on your computer. You also need to have a code editor like Visual Studio or Visual Studio Code with IIS Express. You also need a merging tool like WinMerge or DiffMerge as well. You also need a local copy of your existing site, as well as a new and clean Umbraco Cloud project with at least two environments. Great. So before we actually start on the migration, let's just have a quick look at the site where we're going to migrate. As you can see, we have a site here with a couple of pages and some content on it. Let's try and go to the back office of the project up here. Let's log in. And in here, we can see we have some content notes over here. We have some folders with some images. And if we go to the settings, we can see we have our document types over here. And we have some templates down here. Great. Now we want to migrate this site to Umbraco Cloud. Awesome. So let's just close my project down here and let's get started. The first step is to delete a couple of folders to clean up our project. The first folder we want to delete is in the Umbraco folder over here and in the data folder here. It's the temp folder. So let's go ahead and delete this and let's go back. And here we want to delete the logs folder. So if we take a quick look, we can see that we have a log file in here. So let's go ahead and delete this as well. Now we've actually cleaned up our project and it's ready to be migrated to Umbraco Cloud. Okay, so the next step is that we want to clone down our clean Umbraco Cloud project. So as you can see here, I have an Umbraco Cloud project with a development and live environment. Let's go ahead and clone down the development environment to our local PC. So let's go up here to the development environment and click on the dropdown and click clone. Here we get the URL, let's copy it, and let's use a tool. I use this called a fork here to clone it down. So let's go here. And as you can see, it actually adds all the things I need by itself. I just want to change the folder to one I've created for this specific tutorial. So let's just go here and take this one here. And let's save it here. Yes, great. And then let's clone it down. Great. We've now cloned down my project to my local PC. Let's just open up in the folder here. As you can see, the folder is here. And let's go into the project folder here. And let's run the CS project here. So we run our project in Visual Studio. Great. Let's just wait for it to finish up starting up Visual Studio. And once it's done, we're going to run our project just to have a look and see how it looks like. So let's go up here and start our project. Great. As you can see, the site is now initializing. And let's just wait for it to finish it up. And let's, as you can see, let's just quickly restore from our cloud project. Nothing should be here because we don't have any content. We haven't migrated the site yet. Let's just go to the back office and log in with Umbraco ID here. And let's log in here just to get into the back office. And let's have a quick look around. First of all, you can see we don't have any content. And if we go to the settings section, we don't have any document types or templates, and we don't have any media items as well. Great. Now that we know this, we can start merging our files between the two projects. Great. So as you can see, I have my on-prem site to the left and my cloud project to the right. Now I want to merge the files from my on-prem site to my cloud site. So the first folder that we want to move is the VVV root folder. So let's copy it from over here and paste it in over here. Great. The next one that we're gonna move is the views folder with all our views on our on-prem site. So let's copy it from over here and paste it in over here. Awesome. Lastly, we need to move the Umbraco folder as well, as it contains our database files. In my case, I'm using SQLite. However, if you're using a local SQL server, you need to make sure to update the connection string in the app-setting.json files for your Umbraco Cloud project with your SQL server. Great, so let's go over here and let's copy it. And then let's paste it in over here. Say yes to replace the files, as we don't want to use the cloud database that was generated. Then you also need to make sure that you merge your app-setting.json files with the ones from your existing site so that the settings you used are moved over to your cloud project. You also need to merge your program.cs and startup.cs files with the one from your existing files as well. Okay, let's now take a quick look at how you can merge your app-setting.json files between projects using a tool like WinMerger. Okay. So let's open up WinMerger down here. And as you can see, I already added my files. To the left, I have my Umbraco Cloud project. And to the right, I have my Umbraco on-prem project. As you can see, there's a couple of differences. First of all, I'm using the models builder on my on-prem site. And you can see the connection string as well. So in our case, I want to add the models builder part of my app-setting.json files to my cloud project. I'm not going to add the connection string, as this is something that Umbraco Cloud will add automatically to my project. Awesome. Let's now go to Visual Studio and add the models builder to my Umbraco Cloud app settings JSON file. So let's go to my on-prem site here. And as you can see, I have the models builder down here. Let's copy it. And then let's go to my Umbraco Cloud app settings JSON file and add it there. So let's go to my cloud here. And we have the CMS here, and let's just go one step down and let's paste it in here. Save it. And we have actually now merged our app settings JSON file. Great. Great. Now that we have merged all the files, it's time to verify and see whether everything looks as it should. So do this. Let's run our Umbraco Cloud project. Let's start it up over here. Let's just wait for Visual Studio to open up. Great. Let's now run our site and wait for it to finish up and open it up. And once it's loaded, we should be able to see the content on our local cloud site. But wait, actually, as you can see, we're actually getting an error. Luckily, the error tells us where the issue is, and it's in the view import file. So let's take a look and see if we can quickly fix this error here. So let's go back to Visual Studio over here. Let's just shut down our project. And let's go to our view import file over here. The problem here is that I haven't updated this using statement. It's using the statement from my old site, and I need to change it to Umbraco project down here. Great. Save it, and now your site should work. And now let's go ahead and run our project so we can verify that everything works as expected. So let's wait for it to load here. And bam, as you can see, we now have our content on our local Umbraco Cloud site here. Awesome. So we are almost done. Let's just go to the back office here and log in and verify that we can log in with Umbraco ID, and it works as expected. So let's go ahead and log in. And as we can see, it does. Let's close this one down. And as you can see over here, we have now our content nodes over here. We have our images in the media section. Let's take a look here. As you can see, we have some images. And in the settings section, we now have our document types as well as our templates down here. Awesome. So we are very close to being done now. The next step is that we want to generate our metadata for our document types, templates, and so on. So let's just have a look in our project folder over here, because in the Umbraco folder, if we go in here, we have a folder called deploy and a revision folder. Here we don't have anything, but we want to generate our metadata, which will show up here. So let's go back to the settings section and the deploy section over here. Here we want to run extract schema to data files command from the deploy operations drop down here. So let's choose it down here. And then let's trigger the operation up here. We can see up here that it started, and it will also say that it's done up here. It might take a while to generate the UDA files, depending on how big your site is. Great, as we can see, it says that last deployment operation is completed. And once the export is done, now we run a schema deployment from data files to check whether the UDA files has been generated correctly. So let's trigger the operation. And as you can see, it's in progress now. And it's completed successfully. Let's go back to my revision folder and let's just have a look and see. Great. You can see that it has generated a whole bunch of files, which is all the UDA files for our metadata in my Umbraco Cloud project. And we can now go ahead and push all our changes up to our Umbraco Cloud project. Awesome. Let's go back to my clone tool over here. As you can see, we have a whole lot of changes over here. It's all our metadata, as well as the changes from our project that we moved over as well. So let's stage it all and write a commit message down here. So migrating project to cloud. Let's go ahead and commit all the files. And once we committed all the files, we can go over here and just click on the master branch. And we can see that we have all these new changes that we can then go ahead and push up to our Umbraco Cloud project. Let's go ahead and let's wait for the push to be completed. Great, and once it's done pushing up the changes to our Umbraco Cloud project, let's go back to our browser and log into Umbraco Cloud. Let's log in here. And let's go to my migration project over here. And as we can see, we have some new changes that can be deployed. Let's just quickly go to the back office and make sure that that everything looks as expected. We shouldn't have any content just yet as we haven't transferred it up to our cloud project yet. But our metadata, meaning our document types and templates, should be on our Umbraco Cloud project now. So let's get back into the back office here. Let's close this one down. And as you can see, we don't have any content, but in the back of in the settings section, you can see that we have our document types and we have our templates. Awesome. Now that we have this, let's go back to our local project down here. And let's go to the content section. And now we're going to transfer all our content up to our Umbraco Cloud project. So let's go to a queue for transfer over here and just transfer everything. Let's just close it down because we also want to transfer our media files. And let's queue that for transfer as well. And let's open up the queue here. and let's transfer it to development by clicking the green button here. Great. As you can see, the transfer is now completed and our content should now be on our development environment on Umbraco Cloud. So let's go back to our project and to the content section and refresh the site here. And as you can see, we now have our content in the back office as well. So let's just click on the home node here and let's go and take a look at how the front end looks like. As you can see, we have some content here. Let's have a look at the front end. And as you can see, we now have all our content on our development environment on Umbraco Cloud. Let's take a look around and see that everything looks as it should. Awesome, it does. This means that we have successfully migrated our on-premise Umbraco site to Umbraco Cloud now. Awesome. Thank you so much for watching this video. My name is Jonathan, and I'll see you in the next video. Jonathan, out.